Welcome to this React Diagram tutorial. In this video, you will learn how to create an organizational chart using the Syncfusion React Diagram component. Look at this example, and you can see an organizational chart that represents the information of a company structure. Let us recreate this using the React Diagram component. I open the app.tsx file, to which I have added the diagram component with appropriate height and width. Follow the link in the card above or the description below to learn the basics of adding the React diagram. Now, I run the application using the npm start command in the terminal. The diagram canvas is rendered. To insert JSON data into the diagram component, I will use the Syncfusion Data Manager utility from the Syncfusion Data package. Let me create an array named Diagram Items of type object and paste the node data that I had copied from the Syncfusion Diagram documentation page. Each object has three properties: ID, role, and team. ID acts as the unique identifier, whereas role and team denote the hierarchy of the organizational structure. Using the structure, nodes can be automatically arranged. First, let me import the Data Manager interface from the Syncfusion EJ2 data package, and then I define an instance for the Data Manager, name data, and assign the diagram items as a JSON array parameter. Next, I will create a diagram data variable of class type data source model. So I import the data source model interface from the EJ2 React Diagrams package. Then I define the data source variable and set the properties as ID to ID, which indicates the target node of each connection, parent ID to team, which indicates the source node of a connection. Finally, set data manager to data. Next, let me arrange the nodes using the layout property. I define the diagram layout variable of the layout model type. I import the layout model interface and set the properties layout type to organizational chart, margin top to 20 pixels. Horizontal spacing and vertical spacing to 50 pixels. The horizontal and vertical spacings act as offset values for the nodes. Finally, to position the entire diagram in the center of the canvas, I set the horizontal and vertical alignments to center. Let me assign the variables to their respective property values. No nodes have been rendered because there are no services injected. The Syncfusion React Diagram features are separated into individual modules. So, if I need to bind data and then specify the type of layout for my diagram, I need to import the required services. I now import the data binding, hierarchical tree, and inject services. I inject the services that were just imported and add the closing tag to the diagram component. Now, all the nodes have been rendered in the canvas with their respective connectors, but the nodes have no annotations. To add annotations and style to the diagram, let me use the getNodeDefaults and getConnectorDefaults properties. I define two functions. Firstly, defaultNodeSetting, which takes NodeModelType as the parameter. Secondly, default connector setting that takes connector model as the parameter type. Then I import the node model and connector model interfaces. Next, within the default node setting method, I will add annotations using the annotations property. I set font color using the style property, and the color is set to white. Then I set the content property from the node object. This involves casting the node object to include a role string type, enabling access to node annotations. Next, to define the style of the node, I set several properties. Fill color is set to a specific shade of blue using hex code. The stroke color is set to none, which means the node will not have a border. I also define the dimensions of the node by setting its width to 70 and its height to 40. This provides a consistent size for all nodes in the diagram. Finally, to draw text margin for the node, I set a margin of 5 units on all sides. This ensures that the text does not touch the edges of the node, giving it some padding and making it look cleaner. I will return the node object and then assign this method to the diagram component. You can see the complex JSON data beautifully arranged as an organizational chart. Now I will customize the connectors using the default connector setting method. Starting with the style, I set the stroke width to 2 and stroke color to the same color used for nodes. I apply null check for the connector decorator style and set the fill color and stroke color to the same blue shade. I also set the connector type to orthogonal and return the connector. I set this method into the diagram component. The connectors are neatly arranged alongside the flow. In this video, I showed you how to import JSON data into the React Diagram component and to automatically arrange the JSON using the layout property and data binding service from the Syncfusion library. Additionally, you saw how to use the get default properties to style the nodes and connectors. If you want to see a working example, download one from the GitHub link shared in the description below. I've also included a link in the description to check if you qualify for our community license, giving you a free license key for our entire React suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.